While you might be able to control your physical pain, emotional pain is different. And as Clark County High School students headed back to school for the final few weeks of a very unique school year, there are concerns about new social pressures and mental health. Joining us now is award-winning author Stacy Padula. Thank you so much for joining us. How are you?
Hi, I'm doing great. Thank you so much for having me.
Of course. Well, this is such an important conversation, and you've written young adult novels that help prepare teens to face what you call the social war zone that is high school. Talk to us about the concerns there are surrounding kids going back to school for just a few weeks.
So in addition to being a young adult author, I'm also a college counselor. So I work daily with young adults, mostly juniors and seniors in high school. And what I can tell you is I'm very close with my students, and a lot of them are sharing that they have finally gotten adjusted to online learning. Mm-hmm. You know, they're used to their schedule, they're in their routines, they're used to the technology, and now all of a sudden they're expected to adjust again and go back to school, but it's different than it ever was. So now there's social distancing, there's masks, it's difficult to understand what people are saying. So it is so much adjustments that are being required, you know, by these kids right now, that it's causing a lot of anxiety. And honestly, most of the kids whom I've spoken with have said, we would have just rather finished the year out at home, just knowing what our teachers expect us this way. So I think there's a little bit of anxiety, a little bit of fear of the unknown, and it's just a lot of change to ask of these kids.
And high schoolers, of course, are no stranger to social pressures, whether it's online or in a classroom setting. What makes this situation different?
You know, I think on top of the normal social pressures, you would say, there's also a lot of pressure coming from within for these students, because a lot of them feel like there are some gaps in their learning because of what happened last year and from adjusting to online. So there's a lot of self-pressure on them, as well as the pressure of being now in school in a brand new setting, but not necessarily having all the fun aspects that you would have with school. So, I mean, a lot of my students are saying, great, now we are in the classroom, but we can't even go to the lunchroom. We just sit in the room and have snack like we used to in kindergarten, and we can't talk to our friends. So they might feel the pressure to socialize, but they can't. Then they feel the pressure to learn the new material, but they're missing stuff that they should have learned at the end of the school year last year. So I think the pressures are coming at them from everywhere.
Yeah. And we don't have too much time left, so I want to kind of combine two questions that I have for you that I think are really important. One is, what have you found in your research that's really helped kids, especially teens that aren't so good about talking how they're feeling? And two, what can parents do?
Well, I think that it's very important for kids to feel that they have, whether it is a parent, a pastor, a coach, a mentor, a guidance counselor, someone whom they can speak with honestly. But for kids who don't feel comfortable sharing in that capacity, there are a lot of great books out there that will help them feel like they're not alone. So my books, Gripped and Montgomery Lake High, those two book series were written to really help kids not feel alone and to give them advice that maybe they're afraid to seek out. So, you know, they could look at my books, any books like that. And parents, I would say parents really just need to keep a very close watch on their kids right now for the signs of anxiety or depression. I think a lot of them have lost their identity not being socialized right now. A lot of kids kind of root their identity in their social setting, which they've been removed from for the past year. So I think keeping a close watch on that is crucial right now.
Okay. Stacy, thank you so much. We really appreciate your time.
Thank you.